Hey, welcome back to Dominican Rendezvous. Today, I want to talk about the differences between Haiti and the Dominican Republic. Now, this won't be an all-inclusive, total description of all the differences, but I just wanted to highlight a few differences between Haiti and the Dominican Republic in this video today. I haven't talked much about the Dominican Republic and Haiti. A couple of times in some past videos, I've made brief mention about some of the problems between the Dominican Republic and Haiti. Take a look at those. Just go to the playlist and look for them. You will find them. But today, I just want to talk about a few differences between the Dominican Republic and Haiti. Now, as you know, myself being first and foremost, we love to call the Dominican Republic a paradise. And for real, it is a paradise for many of us coming from the West, whether it's from Europe, Canada, even the United States as well. And we go to the Dominican Republic, it is a paradise. We love its beaches. We love its flora. We love its fauna. We love its mountains. We love its people. We love its cuisine. We love many things about the Dominican Republic. And we know that it is quite possible for those of us coming from the West with the money that we have to live a very comfortable and a wonderfully comfortable life in the Dominican Republic. And for those of us, that can be paradise. But the Dominican Republic is still a relatively poor country. And it is a poor country that borders a country that's even poorer. Haiti. And many times we forget this. We see it. We may recognize it. But I don't think it's fully sat in amongst us that we are fortunate enough to be able to visit or in some cases live in the Dominican Republic by virtue of the fact that we have been blessed to be born in the West, blessed to have a good education, blessed to have good jobs, blessed to have income, blessed to have retirement funds, and blessed to be able to use them in the Dominican Republic. But still, the Dominican Republic is a poor country, neighboring a country that is even poorer. It shares the same island, Hispaniola, where the Dominican Republic shares two-thirds, the country of Haiti shares one-third. And while you see them sharing the same island, you will also notice that there are many, many, many stark contrasts. In my thumbnail today, you will see one of the starkest contrasts, and that being the deforestation photo, if you will, of Haiti versus the Dominican Republic. But another problem is the infrastructure. While the Dominican Republic has reasonable roads and road network throughout the Dominican Republic, Haiti does not. Haiti is more arduous to travel. It takes more time to traverse through Haiti on the roads and the roads that are lacking. Now, I've never been to Haiti, but I have been told this, and from my reading and from my understanding, this is the case. Literacy, comparatively in the Dominican Republic to Haiti, is vastly different. The literacy rate, they say, in the Dominican Republic is around 90%. I've talked about this in my education video. Take a look at that. But in Haiti, we're told that it is about 50% of the population that is literate. Infant mortality in the country of Haiti is said to be 3 to 4 times higher than that in the Dominican Republic. And so you kind of see these differences. Haiti is also, because of its coastline, very susceptible to hurricanes and flooding. And if you know anything about the geography of Haiti, you will notice that most of the cities in Haiti are located along the coastlines. Therefore, most of the population is located among or around the coastlines. And so when these hurricanes come and these waters come and these torrential rains come and all of this water, there's serious flooding. There are earthquakes. We've seen in news of the earthquake in Haiti some years ago. We know also that in Haiti that the supply of electricity is very scarce, has been scarce for some time. And by the way, let me just parenthetically say, I am not trying to disparage Haiti at all. I am not trying to put down Haiti. Please do not get that opinion. I'm just merely stating the facts as I have come to understand them and have come to read and learn about Haiti. So don't misunderstand me that I'm anti-Haiti. No, I'm just drawing a comparison of real life issues. But going back to what I was trying to say is that the supply of electricity in Haiti is lacking and scarce. And as a result, what ends up happening is the people who need some form of power will go out and cut trees for wood, for burning. And this has caused, as I've already mentioned, the deforestation that you see in the country of Haiti. And then when the heavy rains come, this causes landslides, and it's just a disaster. Now, granted, the Dominican Republic also struggles with some of the same issues as far as electricity in some areas. We've talked about that before. I think I've mentioned also in some past videos that the Dominican Republic is starting to really now get a grip on deforestation issues in its country as well. Deforestation is a major, major problem for those of you who are not aware of it. Because once those trees are cut and they are stripped, the land then becomes accessible to mudslides, landslides, and unusable for vegetation or for crops. But yet the Dominican Republic has seemingly addressed this problem and has been addressing this problem and trying to take care of this problem much more so than in Haiti. Now, a little background by way of history. Now, I am not a historian and certainly not a historian on the island of Hispaniola, but what I do know is that much of the history of the island of Hispaniola was under the Spanish reign. And then when the Spaniards left, they then ceded the western section, which is now called Haiti, to the French in the late 1600s. The French brought with them and took with them, if you will, thousands, hundreds of thousands of African slaves to go there and to work in the plantations of cotton, cocoa, and sugar. But after several years of doing this, the slaves then basically had a revolt, and I'm paraphrasing all this and capsulizing it, had a revolt and overthrew the French and gained their independence in the early 1800s. The problem was, after they gained their independence, there were some huge issues that they had to tackle. And primarily, from what my understanding is, the major issue was that because of the amount of Africans that were there, they were from different tribes, and they didn't get along, so I'm told and so I've read. And that created problems. They became instant landowners, but they really didn't have places to live because the land was not suitable for them to live right away. And this was the beginning, really, in a nutshell, of all the problems that have subsequently plagued Haiti with dictators, with monarchs, with overthrows and all, civil unrest and all the things that are going on in Haiti even up until this day. I did not do service to the history of Haiti. I will be the first to tell you that. But please, by all means, go out, read it, search it, study it, make it your own opinion. Correct me if I'm wrong. I'm open to correction. But the French left, as I understand it, and then the country was independent, and then a whole lot of things happened after that, which have just continually continued throughout the years. Now, the Dominican Republic, on the other hand, maintained its stayed under Spanish rule for some time, and then the Spaniards took off and basically went to Mexico. And the Dominicans, if you will, that remained there were obviously, there were some that were from African, but there were also a lot of Europeans that were there as well. And they mixed and they kind of unified a little bit better and basically made things work a little bit better than what the Haitians had done in their situation. Again, I'm capsulizing. The Dominican Republic, as we all know, has had dictators. It has had strong men ruling the country. But yet they've come through. They've done a remarkable job economically and developmentally. And a large part of that has been due to the tourist interests that have been obviously well known in the Dominican Republic, whereas Haiti did not have that. So you kind of see the difference right there between the Dominican Republic and Haitians. Haitians, obviously, nowadays are having a lot of problems. They are a diaspora. They're all over the world. They're going to many different countries, you know, looking for better opportunity. And the Dominican Republic is no exception. If I may say to them, the Dominican Republic, to us, as well as it is to us, is a paradise. It is a paradise to them, probably for different reasons. It is a paradise to Haitians because it gives them an opportunity for a job. It gives them an opportunity for shelter. It gives them an opportunity to put food on the table for their families and for their foods. It improves their living conditions. And that also could be paradise for them. Hope you got a better understanding. I know it's very brief. I know it's very abbreviated. But I just wanted to give you kind of a very brief, precursory introduction, if you will, to part of the problem between the Dominican Republic and Haiti and why there's such a massive difference between the two countries in one aspect. From me to you, Dominican Rendezvous.